Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this presentation of CBL basketball on the Coliseum Sports Network. From the PPL Center in Allentown, Pennsylvania, it's the Las Vegas Silver Stars and the Lehigh Valley Jets. I'm glad you could join us here for week four action as we enter the interconference schedule. The first game between the Eastern Conference and the Western Conference facing off, and it's on Eastern Conference soil here as the undefeated Jets will play host to the 1-2 Silver Stars, who hope to end the week at 500, while the Lehigh Valley Jets, of course, hope to get the win at home and remain undefeated in the CBL. That will definitely go a long way towards their playoff chances. Hard to be knocked off the top when you don't have a loss to your name. Kenyon Martin and Roy Hibbert, jumping center. And here's the tip, and we're underway from Allentown. Lehigh Valley winning it. We're ready to go here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Glad that you could join us. Here's Kobe Bryant denied inside. And here comes Westbrook on the run. Bounce pass ahead to Lou Williams, who throws it down and gets the shot and one. And Kenyon Martin called for his first foul. Today, an interesting tactical matchup made by the head coach for Las Vegas, Dedrick Frazier. He has Lou Williams starting at point guard with Russell Westbrook starting at the two guard. Chances are Westbrook will still be running the point as Williams makes the free throw, while Lou Williams will still be playing the off guard. Frazier making that decision so that Westbrook, who is the better on-ball defender between him and Williams, it faces off against Kobe Bryant, who has slowly gotten hotter with each passing week. He started the season scoring 8 points in a loss to Kansas City as he draws the foul. Then got 16 in week two. Or got 21, rather, in week two. He had 8 points, 6 rebounds, 10 assists in week one. 21 points in week two. Went off for 36 last week in that victory against Omaha. So here's Kobe Bryant at the line, ready to get things going here for himself as he scores the first point. And he drew a foul on Westbrook. It'll be interesting to see how well the 6'3 Westbrook, who we know is a very good defensive player, we see how he holds up against Kobe Bryant if Kobe can be stopped here in this short season CBL. He's able to get both free throws at the line, and it's 3-2 as we're just over 30 seconds into this week four matchup. Here's Danny Granger, who's also found the fountain of youth this season. He misses, however. And here comes Lehigh Valley the other way. Williams fighting his way into the lane, lays it up and in past Hibbert. And that'll be the other quandary there. If Dedrick Frazier feels that Lou Williams isn't good enough to guard Kobe, how well is he going to guard Deron Williams, who has been talented in his own right? Here's Granger putting up the long two, and that'll give Las Vegas the lead back up by one. 10:40 remaining in the first quarter. Been pretty back and forth early on. Both teams getting a trip to the line each. Ball down low. Here's Bryant posting up. Low block action. Kicks it back out to Williams. Williams inside, shoots over Williams, and is able to give Lehigh Valley the lead back once again. Here's Westbrook taking on Bryant. Ball to Williams. He'll put up the three, and he'll miss. Rebound Griffin going back up for it, draws the foul. 2 minutes in, and we have three fouls between both teams. So here's Blake Griffin, who, if you compare his numbers here in the CBL against his NBA numbers, and it's a small sample size still, but in a 10-game season, it's all going to be a small sample size. 13.7 points a game and 12 rebounds here in the CBL, which is different from the 20 plus points and the 8+ rebounds that he averages regularly in the NBA. So he's been look to attack the boards a lot more. And he scored a little less. He really, the reason it's at 13.7 is he makes the second free throw as well as that 8-point game that he had in week two. Otherwise, he's been getting about 16, 17 points. 7-6 here, Vegas leading. Pretty much been back and forth between the LVs. Deron Williams knocking down the tray. And that'll give the Jets a slightly more decisive lead, up by two. 9.5 remaining in the first quarter. So Deron Williams has gotten going early on. But Lou Williams able to strike back, and Vegas back up by one. So we might end up seeing a shootout there at the point guard position between Lou and Deron Williams. And a defensive matchup here between Westbrook and Bryant. That's where a lot of action has been taking place early on here. We'll see if DeRozan at small forward can get going. He'll miss his first shot. Evans goes up, he's stripped, and the ball is taken away by Roy Hibbert. Vegas with a chance to go up by more. Kicks it over. That's Williams, long two. No good. Offensive board snatched away by Granger, and he'll go up and draw the foul. So Danny Granger, he's been putting up numbers that we have not seen from him since his days in Indiana. He'll go to the line. He had a bit of a drop-off in week three. Makes the first free throw. After scoring 18 and 25 in the first two games, he had only 11 in week three, but he's still been a major presence here for Las Vegas, even though they're only 1-2. They're going to need some production out of him if they want to get the win here in Allentown. He knocks down both of his free throws, does what he has to do with the charity stripe, and Las Vegas is now up by three. And that's the largest lead on either side so far. It's been a tight one here. With these two stacked rosters feeling each other out. Bryant, top of the key, knocks it down. A little under 8.5 left here in the first quarter. Here's Griffin. Gives it back to Williams. Back up top, Granger at the point. Silver Stars trying to run a set here. It gets back to Griffin. Now it's decision time for Blake. He'll put up the long two and is able to take care of business. So the pressure was coming with the clock, but he was not deterred. And both teams have made 4 field goals early on. Evans back up top. Deron inside, shoots it, baseline jumper is good. Closes the gap to one. So Deron Williams has been able to find a number of shooting opportunities, 9 points already, and has yet to miss. Here's Granger, and he misses, rebound by Evans. In the corner by himself, DeRozan. No good. Rebound. Bryant underneath lays it up, and he misses. Rebound by Granger. Lou Williams pull up three. No good. Bryant just in front of the 3-point line gives Lehigh Valley the lead back almost halfway through the first quarter. Oh, and that pass intended for Lou Williams goes out of bounds. Westbrook with his first turnover of the game. Averaging 4 a game is Westbrook. He had 7 in week 2. That was a rough game for sure. Reed up top, works around to DeRozan. Double teamed, shakes off Griffin, but Granger still playing tight. And now it's Evans on the perimeter. He's probably going to put it up. No, tried to get it off to Williams, and Westbrook was right there. What's Russ going to do? Turnaround jumper off the backboard and in. And exactly halfway through the first quarter, Vegas up by one. Here's Williams on the wing. Works it up top to DeRozan. He'll go to work here against Granger. Hands it off. Evans, shot in the post, no good. Faried will get his opportunity to clean up the mess. And there's the first chance there for Kenneth Faried as he'll get it up and in, give Lehigh Valley the lead 17-16 with 5:35 left here in the first quarter. Going to be a great week of interconference action here on the Coliseum Sports Network. After this game, we'll be heading back over to England for the first time in a couple of weeks as the two international sides here in the CBL, Mexico City and London, will face off for the only time this season. That'll be tomorrow on the Coliseum Sports Network. But in the meantime, here in Allentown, we got a good one so far. Back and forth, Westbrook gliding in, layup good. And out of the timeout, the Silver Stars get the lead back. Not sure what Dedrick Frazier drew up in the huddle during that last timeout, but it could have very well just been a one, then an arrow towards the basket, because that's exactly what happened as DeMar DeRozan drives in. And he'll put the Jets back in front. Williams works off the Amundsen screen and knocks down the tray. And so the Silver Stars have the advantage yet again, but for how long? As back and forth as it's been, it may change in a matter of seconds. Williams up top to DeRozan. On the baseline, DeRozan hasn't been able to figure out how to get past Granger. At least not yet. Two men on him, and Deron Williams still able to knock down the fadeaway jumper. 21 all. Williams will just take the shot from here. He'll miss, and rebound corralled by Jeremy Evans. Reach in foul on the Silver Stars. That will be on Griffin, who will sit out for the time being. Kobe Bryant will also take a seat, the man who drew the foul. And now here's the second unit. Terrence Ross goes right to work, but there's Kenneth Faried to pick up where Ross left off. That was good defense there by Anthony Bennett, but he couldn't take on both guys. And Lehigh Valley able to get the lead. No one's budged yet, but it's really going to be interesting to see what gives either side the advantage. First shot up by Shabazz Muhammad is no good, but Anthony Bennett able to collect it, and here's a second chance opportunity for the Silver Stars. Westbrook still out on the court, gets it to CJ Watson. So this will be a side effect here of Westbrook starting the two. His backup, Watson, will be in at the same time as he is, as Amundsen can't get the shot inside. Here's Mo Harkless. Pushes it way ahead to Ross, and he'll have to kick it way back out to Pressey. Ross can't knock down the three, and the only person there to get it, Anthony Bennett. Here's Westbrook. He thought about going into the lane, but loses his dribble. Up top is Watson. Here's CJ trying to fight his way inside. Gets past Pressey. And that will be a loose ball. Goes out of bounds. And Anthony Bennett was, in fact, the last man to touch it. So the ball will go to Lehigh Valley. Westbrook will finally take a breather. James Ennis will come into the game for the Silver Stars. 2.5 remaining here in the first quarter. And now both teams' second units out on the floor. This may very well be where the difference falls. The bench, namely Gerald Green, has been very useful for Lehigh Valley, and it's helped to get them where they are. While the Silver Stars bench hasn't had the most production over the course of 3 weeks. But can the Silver Stars bench hold it down for the starters? We'll have to find out here. It's still 23-23 as Ennis was able to get the layup. 140 left in the first, 100 seconds. Pressey works it over to Ross. And here's Gerald Green. He was about to go to work. But Muhammad coming back down drew the foul. Green got him to bite, and he pays for it. Kenyon looking for Gerald Green, finds him again, and Green draws the foul. And the Jets, or specifically Gerald Green, getting fouled twice under the two-minute mark, puts Lehigh Valley in the bonus just like that. Gerald Green has absolutely been eaten off the bench for Lehigh Valley. He's able to knock down the first free throw. Had 20 and had 18 in the first 2 weeks, and that was both in 19 minutes of play. He got a little less time off the bench last week, but he was still able to score 12 points. So, much like most of his career, he's been able to find a niche off the bench. He doesn't have a problem contributing from that role. He just knows when the time comes, it's time to go to work. He picks up 2 points at the line, and Amundsen picks up 2 points under the rim. So it's 25-25 with a little over a minute left here in the first quarter. So even with the backups out on the floor, not much of an advantage on either side yet. Ross for three. And the Jets take a 28-25 lead. Finally under a minute here in the first. Watson up the floor for Vegas. Here's Bennett back up top. Watson for three. And he ties it up at 28. Just when you thought there was some space there off that Ross three, Watson answers right back. Been an amazing first quarter. No ground gained by anyone. Here's Ross. He'll miss that three. That was a rebound by Green. I thought Muhammad had it and was out of bounds. Apparently not the case. Here we are ahead. Bennett, forced shot on the elbow. And the Jets come right back down the floor with it. Here's Ross. Tries to get it underneath Martin. All-star game level scoring here early on. Closing seconds of the first. Vegas would love to get the advantage. Here's Watson knocking down the three, and the Silver Stars go up with 5 seconds left in the first. Can Pressey run the floor in time? He's there, and he can't get it at the buzzer, but a good shot on goal there. And yes, it has been a very tight one here for the LVs. Silver Stars come out on top, though, 31-30 after one. As we start off the second quarter here at the PPL Center in Allentown, Pennsylvania. You gotta love action like this. And if you do love action like this, be sure to leave a like on this video. And if you want more CBL action, we're still not even halfway through the season and it's been a tight race to the finish already. Be sure to subscribe here to the Coliseum Sports Network. Las Vegas starts off the quarter with possession. Watson hands it off. Anthony Bennett up top. No good. Rebound. Ennis putting it back up. and he draws the foul. James Ennis didn't have to exert too much effort there. He got the ball. All he had to do was go right back up with it, and the refs reward him with the foul. So here's Ennis at the line, and he's able to get the and one. 3 points on that possession. And Vegas pulls ahead by four, and that's the largest lead here in this game so far. That's how tight it's been. Green fakes underneath Kenyon Martin. Jets have been doing a good job to find him under the basket as Kenyon Martin delivers another throwdown. 2-point game. Jets not too far behind. Here's Bennett. He'll miss. Amundsen going to go back up with it and lays it in. Still up by four are the Silver Stars. 14 lead changes, five ties. Green in the corner. He thought about it. Here's Ross. He'll go for it. Miss. Rebound by Martin. Now Green's open to put up the three and knock it down. And Lehigh Valley back within one. That play was moving fast enough that it kept me from mentioning that Green usually takes threes like that. But he waited it out. He was patient. He saw the opportunity. And he drains one to bring the Jets back within one. Silver Stars aren't getting the lead that easy, says the Jets, and they're only up by one with 10:32 left in the second quarter. Hibbert back in the game for Vegas, but it seems like everybody else is still remaining in the game. Ennis gets the inbound. Here's Bennett. And Pressey. Draw the foul there. Fell for the pump fake. And Anthony Bennett will go to the line. Anthony Bennett, first overall pick in 2013 out of UNLV, was a huge shock at that position. Picked up by the Cavaliers. Eventually found himself as a casualty of LeBron coming home. So he ended up in Minnesota. Went scoreless in the first 2 weeks and then out of nowhere explodes for 8 points and five rebounds last week. Shot missed, so not able to convert at the line. Didn't make a free throw there, but Green able to knock down the jumper. I was going to say that Bennett hadn't made a free throw all season yet, but he did go 2-for-4 for the line last week. So I got a little mixed up there. But Lehigh Valley able to take the lead back off of that empty free throw trip there by Bennett. Here's Watson just going to pull up for three and drain it. 39-37. And as Pressey comes across the line, Silver Stars managed to take the lead back there, as they're up by two with 9:42 left in the second. Early in the second quarter, and Las Vegas has had the slight plus-minus advantage here in the second quarter, but Lehigh Valley absolutely not going away yet. Here's Green, gets the ball in the corner. Now it's Harkless back up top. Green kicks it back out. Little two-man game as the Jets try to sort things out. Green finally gets a lane. So that seemed to be the mandate there on that possession. They were just going to work that ball back and forth until Gerald Green saw the opening. Something like a big man lineup out here on the floor for Las Vegas. It's done them well so far. Ennis goes up and draws the foul. So Gerald Green will get his first. And back to the line again is James Ennis out of Long Beach State. Spent last season with the Miami Heat. Still there now. So he's going to look to develop. He hasn't had the biggest role here with Vegas early on in the season. He's only scored 2 points coming into this game. Even though he played in all three games. So a scoring average, a paltry 0.7 points per game. And that free throw makes it a 2-point game. 9 minutes left in the second quarter. Lehigh Valley. Slight deficit. And Gerald Green cannot close the gap. So here's Ennis running the floor for Las Vegas. Finds his way inside. Draws the foul on Green again. And they'll give him the continuation. That whole possession was a bit of a surprise. He had Ennis bringing the ball up out of the backcourt and then attacking the basket and then drawing the foul. And he's able to finish off with a 3-point play. So Dedrick Frazier getting a lot more production out of Ennis than he's had out of him all season. Here's Gerald Green suddenly with two fouls. Ball to Harkless. Works it back outside. And Martin will go back up. He'll draw the foul. That'll be on Hibbert. Kenyon Martin has officially retired from the NBA. So he's spending his last games here in the CBL before calling it a career. And he's been incredibly useful as the team's starting center. He does miss the first free throw. His first free throw attempt of the season. But he's been pretty good underneath. Definitely still has some rim protector left in him in case he wants to make a comeback. He got 11 boards last week and he's been averaging 2.3 blocks a game. Can't convert on the free throw, so now Lehigh Valley suddenly down by 5. Westbrook back in the game. Looking to exacerbate Lehigh Valley's problem, but he can't do it there as we pass the 8-minute mark. Here's Ross. It's a long 2. Or that's a 3. They're going to give him a 3. I thought his foot was on the line, but alas, the Jets are within 2. Terrence Ross has had a little trouble finding his footing. 2 for 5 from outside. And here's Hibbert. But he'll give it back. Here's Hibbert going to try again. And he'll miss for Reed with the board. Ross in the corner. Knocks it down. 44 all, so Lehigh Valley was down by as much as 5, but here they are back in it. Here's Watson for 3, and now Lehigh Valley has a chance to take the lead. Slight 5-0 run, but if it becomes 7, oh, it's a problem now. Phil Pressey gets one up in the air, and Faried comes down with it. Lehigh Valley leading the league in dunks by a considerable margin. Came into the game with 20. Here's Watson. Answers back with a 3. So even after the crowd-raising play, Watson silences them by giving the Silver Stars the 1-point lead. Shot missed by Ross. Harkless came around. I thought that Pressey was going to get it to him. Got it to Ross in the corner instead. And not that he can't make the shot, but it looked like there's a little more defense on him. There's the Silver Stars. Westbrook up top. Muhammad trying to go to work against Faried. Good luck with that. Gets it underneath to Hibbert, who loses the ball. So now the Jets can get the lead back again, as they've had so many times before. Pressey on the low block has to kick it back out. Ross will put up the three, as Muhammad didn't play him hard enough, but he can't convert. And here we are with 5.5 left in the second quarter. Las Vegas looking to extend their lead. Here's Westbrook going to work against Terrence Ross. Posting up underneath, Hibbert goes up, lays it in. 3-point game. Vegas has held the lead for the majority of the quarter, but it has not been that wide of a margin. They stave off a 7-0 run and thwart another alley-oop connection. Here's Hibbert facing up against Faried. Now here he is in trouble. Bailed out on a reach-in foul by Faried. That foul will put Vegas in the bonus. So here's Hibbert at the line. First shot goes up and in as the Silver Stars hit the half-century mark. With that swish, number of starters on both sides come back in. Jeremy Evans actually comes in for the starter, Martin. Roy Hibbert cracked double digits for the first time last week when he had 10 points. He had 10 points combined in the first 2 weeks, as he's able to knock down both free throws, and that gives the Silver Stars their 5-point lead back that they had lost temporarily. Here's Gerald Green, puts it up quickly, and there's a three, and that'll close the gap to two right off the bat. So Green already with 12 points. That's the microwave that he is off of the bench, and the reason he gets extended minutes off the bench. Definitely a huge contributor to this 3-0 record that the Jets have. But we'll see if that's enough here in this game. Westbrook, fadeaway, blocked by Faried. Great defensive possession by the Jets. Forced Westbrook into a mismatch, kept all the other options sealed. And the Jets able to force a turnover. So now here's the chance to take advantage, down by two, with 4 minutes. Bryant, he had to change his shot. As he attacked the basket, he thought he had an opening there in the lane, and it just closed up. Westbrook back out to Lou Williams. Shot missed, tipped around, and Evans will snatch away the board. Here's Green in the corner. And he almost made Granger rue the day that he didn't contest that shot closely or deny Green the ball. Granger on the other end, and Ennis with the putback slam. He came out of nowhere. In full disclosure, I thought that he went back to the bench. I thought all of the Silver Star starters were back in the game, but no. James Ennis, he is still here, and he just let the crowd know. 3:10 left here in the second quarter. Bryant pulls up. He had just enough of an opening for his liking, not able to convert. Here's Williams pushing it up the floor. Stopped by Deron. Gets it to Granger, and he can't convert. So here's Bryant as the Jets pushing it up the floor. Silver Star is able to close out on D. Here's James Ennis taking on Kobe. There's a welcome to the league moment. Evans gets it back down, Kobe. Not a lot of time left on the shot clock. Not a problem. 2:30 left here in the second quarter, as we're approaching halftime. As I said before, the Silver Stars have had the slight lead. And it gets bigger again, back up to 5. That's about the high water mark here in this game. But still, Silver Stars had the slight advantage, but not too much here in this game yet. But we'll see if the Silver Stars are on the brink of breaking away, or if the Jets have something else up their sleeve. Lehigh Valley looking to stay 4-0. Deron Williams with the post hook. Nifty shot goes up and in. 100 seconds left in the second quarter. And with 99 of them left, Dedrick Frazier will call timeout. His team is still up by 3, however, trying to maintain that lead heading into the half. And it's set to inbound. He'll find Lou. Up top, Westbrook. Oh, loses the ball, goes back up. And gets the easy post shot. Shot missed by Bryant. Rebound by Griffin. Under a minute here. Down underneath, here's Westbrook. Goes up. And a foul drawn. There's DeRozan with his first. As Westbrook will head to the line. And Westbrook knocks down the free throw. That does give Vegas their largest lead of the game now. At 6, Martin comes into the game in place of Faried. So the head coach for Lehigh Valley today, Jeff Seymour, has apparently given Jeremy Evans a little more country off the bench. And that's a 7-point lead, so now that's the largest lead of the game. Just over 30 seconds left here in the first half, and Las Vegas, even with the nifty layup by Kobe, seems to have taken a slight advantage here. I was saying earlier it was going to be interesting to see what exactly it is that puts either team over the edge. And it seems that the bench was what won out there in the second quarter. And now the starters are back in, really just adding on to the foundation that was set by the second unit. Bryant pulls up, trying to bring the Jets back into it before the half is over. He does close the gap back to 5. But the Silver Stars can score here to get momentum heading into the half. And that goes off the backboard and in. So with 1.2 seconds, Westbrook still looking for some calls here. We'll see if he'll get them in the second half. But for now, the Silver Stars pull ahead in the second quarter. And now they're up by 7 heading into the break. Welcome back to the beautiful, still new, PPL Center in Allentown, Pennsylvania. The homestanding Lehigh Valley Jets, who come into the game undefeated, are down by 7. Coming out of halftime. Well, Vegas, 1-2, looking to get to 500 in their first game in the interconference schedule, in the interconference portion of the schedule. are up by 7 and start off with possession. Both teams having a heck of a half. Shot missed and rebound corralled by Kenyon Martin. Both teams shooting above 50% from the field. Vegas shooting 52 and Lehigh Valley shooting 55. That's not going to help the percentage. Not a surprise, however, for Lehigh Valley. They lead the league in field goal percentage at 54%. Granger missing. And here come the Jets. Bryant tried to get it to Martin, who was filling one of the lanes, and ends up losing the ball. Here's Granger trying to do the same. He'll go up and draw the foul. Can't get the first one. But yeah, Danny Granger averaging double figures for the first time since the lockout season. Definitely has found some new source here in the CBL. And we'll see if he can carry this production with him to Detroit, where he signed a contract over the offseason. As the NBA season's coming closer than you think. DeRozan pulls up, misses, rebound by Martin. He'll go up, and he gets the shot, and one. Hibbert called for a second foul, and Martin going to the line to try to finish off the job with the and one opportunity. Free throw goes up and in. 4-point game. So Vegas bringing up the floor, has yet to score here in the third quarter. Jets trying to close the gap. Westbrook goes in for the slam! Wow, it seemed innocent enough on that drive because it didn't seem like he went in with a full head of steam, but then he saw the chance to finish, and did he ever, as the Silver Stars go back up by 6. Here's Faried. Gets it to Kobe. Tries to answer back. And good disruption by Griffin. Here's Westbrook on the run. Tries to hand it off to Williams. And he's able to convert on the baseline jumper. 8-point game, and that's the largest lead for the Silver Stars. That pass intended for DeRozan went behind him. Was not able to get it. Just not a good possession there for Lehigh Valley. So the second unit was able to get the slight foot in the door in terms of a margin for Las Vegas. And here the Silver Stars picking up where they left off. Westbrook underneath goes up. He'll miss. Griffin has to clean up the mess there. And now Vegas has a 10-point lead. Pick from Faried. And Griffin gets too handsy there. Call for the reach in. And so we'll have a quick timeout here as the Silver Stars take control up by 10. Here's Martin. Gets it to Deron Williams. He'll get the ball, goes in instantly, and can't shoot it over Griffin. Rebound by Granger. Lou was about to drive the lane. And on the size-up dribble, he's fouled by Deron Williams. Here's Westbrook. He'll shoot it. Just enough space, but he'll miss. Rebound by Faried. Here's Williams. Gets it to DeRozan. Gets past Granger and can't convert. Ball ahead to Granger. He'll lay it in. 12-point game as the Silver Stars are on an 8-0 run. Vegas came into the half ahead by 7. The Jets were able to close it to 4, and you thought that Lehigh Valley was on to something there. And then next thing you know, an 8-0 run out of Vegas, and Deron Williams finally able to answer back. We'll see if that squelches the run. Oh, big slam down low by Roy Hibbert. Wasn't a lot of resistance there, just DeRozan under the hoop. So it seemed like it was just a short stop gap, that Deron Williams jumper. We'll see if Lehigh Valley can generate any more offense here, as they are down by 12. Here's DeRozan. He's inside, and he's denied by Hibbert, who then collects his own board. And a rough day so far here for DeRozan. You wondered how Kobe and Deron Williams would work out with that switch between Russell Westbrook and Lou Williams as the starting guards, and seems like DeRozan has been more of a casualty to the switch and the type of defense that Vegas is playing, as they're now up by 14. Fans getting antsy here in Allentown, but Williams saying, do not fear. He's going to try to take care of business. He already has 17, and we aren't even halfway through the third. But Lehigh Valley going to need more. Here's Williams, pulls up and misses over Kobe. And here's Kobe, hands it off, DeRozan underneath, shot and the foul! Before that layup, DeRozan one of six from the field, but there's a way to get you back into the swing of things. And one opportunity is definitely one of those ways. Jeremy Evans comes in, Jets down by 10. Made free throw would put them back within single digits. And that's exactly what happened. 6:59 left in the third quarter. Lou from long distance. And Lou with the rebound. Amundsen goes up. He'll miss. But then he'll get the board again. Ball eventually works its way back down. Griffin able to get the shot on the low block. That possession, there was a lot of frenetic ball movement there. All very smooth, all very crisp, interesting to see. And then eventually it just ended with Griffin laying it in softly. So an 11-point lead here for Las Vegas. And Lehigh Valley coming out of the timeout, going to look to close the gap again. Ball inbounded to Kobe. DeRozan drives inside. Hands it off to Evans, however. Ah, the fadeaway jumper, no good by Bryant. That would have been a pretty make there. But Bryant not able to put it in. Williams to Westbrook in the corner. Three-pointer made by Russell Westbrook. 19 points for Russ. And Bryant able to lay it in. So it looked like trouble there for a millisecond. Turned into a blessing for the Jets. As a disruptive pass by Westbrook opened up the lane for Kobe. Shot missed. Rebound by DeRozan. And Williams gets the easy lay-in. Deron Williams has had a field day, 9 of 11 from the field. By far his best performance so far this season. Granger underneath, Griffin finishing with the slam and one. And the free throw's good. Vegas up by 13. There's Kobe. Fader, no good. Collected by Granger. Ball up top to Williams. Granger can't control the ball. Stolen by Lehigh Valley. And Williams got a little too fancy with the pass. And what could have been a fast break opportunity and a good one ends up as another turnover for the Jets. 4 minutes left now in the third. Granger does it again. Stolen by DeRozan. And he's going to finish this time. And one. So Granger just having a bad day all around on two consecutive possessions. He forgets how to handle a pass. And even though he lucked out on the first one, wasn't so lucky the second time. Free throw made. It's a 10-point game with 3:51 left in the third quarter. Here comes Las Vegas up the floor. They've had a comfortable double-digit lead here for a while. As Westbrook can't knock down the three. Yeah, this sizable lead that the Silver Stars have had, it seemed like the new normal for a while, even though the Jets have been trying their hardest to claw back. DeRozan, he seems to have found his touch a little better here in the second half. He only missed five of his last six shots, of his first six shots rather, and he's been able to pick up the pace since then. Granger, able to recover the offensive board and go up and get the lay-in. So he redeems himself for now. Jets timeout as the Silver Stars still lead by 10. Williams going inside, lays it up and in. Deron Williams has had the uncanny knack of finding the open lanes to drive inside. And his layups almost go essentially uncontested. Lou Williams for three. As Deron Williams was not able to contest that shot in time. Seven-point game. Bryant stopped by Russell as to kick it back out. Going to reset here with Kobe. Here's Deron Williams. Turnaround fadeaway. No good from the free throw line. Faried goes back up and he'll lay it in. Under 2 minutes left here in the third quarter. Kenneth Faried with 8 points. All under the rim tonight. Lehigh Valley still in it. Just going to have to make a few key stops down the stretch, down by 9. There's one of them is Hibbert. Can't convert over Martin. Bryant pulls up. Jumper no good. Offensive board by Martin, and he's able to lay it in. Back to a 7-point game. So a slight run here by the Jets. Dedrick Frazier picks up on it, calls timeout. His team's still up by 7, though, late in the third. Vegas out of the timeout, still up 7, but the Jets are creeping closer. They've been up by as much as 14. Westbrook under the rim. Maybe too far under it. He tried to put out that shot behind the basket. That didn't work out. So a turnover on him. Got to know where you are on the floor at all times. D. Will tried to get it to D. Rose. Ball ahead to Westbrook. Uncontested layup is good. Under a minute remaining in the third. Vegas with some slight momentum out of the timeout. Oh, but Kobe has a thing or two to say about that. The emphatic jam had to hang on the rim there for a little more emphasis. We'll see if that sends a message heading into the quarter break. Jets are still there, down by 7. Here's Griffin taking on Faried. Trying to back down Faried, not having a good time, but still able to convert the 2. 26.7 left in the third quarter. Blake Griffin, 13 points. So he's reached his average in 3 quarters. Where you have a point left if you round up. Williams open 3. And that's good. Brings the Jets within 6. Here's Westbrook. Can't convert. Rebound by Martin. We'll see if the Jets can get down the floor in time. They cannot. And Brian can't get the heave. So the Jets lost control there for a little while, but they're still there, down by only 6 heading into the fourth. Been a good game here in Allentown, Las Vegas up 93-87. If you've enjoyed this game, be sure to give this video a like. And if you enjoy CBL action, be sure to subscribe here to the Coliseum Sports Network for more CBL basketball and more leagues coming down the pipe as we head into the 2015-16 sports season. 11.5. As we are just starting off the fourth quarter, and Las Vegas comes up empty on their first offensive possession. Here's Lehigh Valley, and there's Kobe Bryant going up for the jam and the foul. And Blake Griffin finds himself in a spot of trouble as far as fouls go. While Kobe Bryant has had 2 emphatic jams here in the second half, which has served as message senders that even though the Silver Stars have had control through much of the middle of this game, the Jets are still there and still capable of getting back in it. As they are now down by 3 and we're back to having a ball game. We'll see if the Silver Stars have anything to say about that. Watson in the game, by the way, to replace Williams. Granger underneath to Griffin. and he's able to lay it in. Got some other subs here in the game, including Moat Harkless and Phil Pressey. Here's Pressey against Watson. Fadeaway jumper, no good. And the rebound picked up by Griffin. Here's Watson. Ball up top. And Watson knocks it down. So at least for the time being, Silver Stars on a 5-0 run. Here's Kobe. He's going to try to answer back, and he does. That's a long two, so still a six-point game with under 10 left in the fourth quarter. Kobe Bryant with 21 points. So even with the defensive change, he's still been going to work here in this game. You could argue it's usually because he finds himself away from Westbrook a lot of the time. Harkless draws a foul there as Westbrook, speaking of which, is able to get to the line himself. Westbrook himself has had a heck of a game too. So both sides getting theirs, and both teams have been shooting very well heading into this quarter. At the half in particular, both teams over 50%. And Westbrook able to knock it down as the Silver Stars hit the century mark. Been a high-scoring game here in Allentown. All down low to Bryant. Goes up and misses under the rim. And Griffin able to collect. Here comes Granger. Forces his way past DeRozan and lays it in. Back up to a 10-point game. 7-2 run. 9-2 run. Pardon the bad math. But a 9-2 run, make that 9-4. As Lehigh Valley was able to get within three. And then Vegas takes off again. Watson trying to work his way out of the backcourt is able to get it to Westbrook, who steps back too far. And even though Westbrook has 23 points, he has a number of turnovers, which he's been plagued with all season. Williams downloaded for Reed. Hook shot over Griffin. Tries to go up for the second chance. Denied on both opportunities. Here's Westbrook. Goes inside. Hands it off. Hibbert. And he's denied by Martin. Vegas able to keep it. Watson can't knock down the three. Here's Bryant ahead. Gets it to Williams. Baseline. Jumper is good. Granger, oh, not a good three there, but Griffin able to pick up the pieces. I don't think anybody was there for that air ball. I think Granger just missed. But with that jumper, Lehigh Valley is now allowed the most points in a game for them all season. Bryant can't answer back. Rebound by Griffin. Lehigh Valley allowed 102 to London back in week two. Of course, that was still a win. Granger misses another one. Rebound Hibbert. And he'll go up. Can't get the second chance. And here comes Lehigh Valley going to look to close the gap, get to 100 themselves. Williams denied by Watson. And that pass gets ahead to Granger, and he'll lay it in. 106-96. Coming into this game, Lehigh Valley allowed 92 points a game in three games, but that was partly because they only gave up 77 to Kansas City. So that's really influenced their average so far. This is surely to drive it up. Bryant going inside, lays it up and misses. And here comes Las Vegas as they're trying to put the pedal to the metal here down the stretch. Granger able to knock down the jumper. At the beginning of this very quarter, Lehigh Valley was within three. It looked like they were threatening, and all of a sudden, Vegas pulls away in a major way. Ooh, Bryant able to get the nice hook over Russell Westbrook. Full court attack here out of the Jets. And almost getting the 8-second violation. Bryant bails him out with a reach-in foul. Under 6 minutes left here in regulation. And Granger, he'll get it back to Lou Will. And that's thrown cross-court, intended for Hibbert, and out of bounds. We've entered football season, so we're probably seeing a lot more of those. More so on the field than on the court. 10-point game. It's getting late early here for the Jets. Williams on Williams. And Deron can't win out. Lou with the rebound. Here's Williams underneath. He'll force it up anyway. And Faried with the rebound. Deron Williams trying to run the set here. Let's see what happens. Stripped away and stolen by Lou Williams. Silver Stars on the run. DeRozan the man back. Gets it back to Westbrook on the secondary break and can't convert. And the ball is just everywhere right now. Lou Williams tried to save it, and it will be on him. So with 4:48 left in the fourth, Lehigh Valley will get possession here. DeRozan for three. Can't close the gap. Faried gets the Jets a second opportunity. Underneath, intended for Martin, and he'll draw the foul. Reach in, called on Hibbert. So Martin back to inbounding. Lehigh Valley still haven't yet to crack the century mark. They'll try to do it on this possession. And then in the process try to close the gap on this deficit. But Las Vegas is taking care of business. They faltered a little bit to start off the quarter, but they've gone to work since then. Bryant knocks it down, and Lehigh Valley hitting 100. They average 100.7 points per game coming into this matchup. Loses the ball. Here's Deron Williams. Lays it up and in the backcourt. A backcourt steal by Deron Williams. And he has 30 points. And that was a risk there for Dedrick Frazier, moving Westbrook to the two guard. The fact that Lou Williams, even if you move him to the one, he's still taking on an all-star guard at that position as well. And while Williams has done great on the offensive end, you see he has 20 points. The man he's supposed to be guarding has 10 more than him at 30. So Dedrick Frazier had to decide, do you want Kobe to go off or do you want Deron Williams to go off? Here's Kobe. He'll miss, but get his own board. He'll try again over Hibbert, his upcoming teammate. He'll miss again, and Martin will be the one to draw the foul there. Yes, there's that factor as well. that Lou Williams and Roy Hibbert, two of the newest Lakers to join for the 2015-16 season, taking on their upcoming teammate Kobe Bryant, who may or may not be playing his final season of NBA basketball. Though when it's all said and done, we'll definitely be able to consider Kobe as one of the greats. And Martin missing the free throw, so it's a 111-102 with 3:13 left in the fourth. And Hibbert hangs around the perimeter for too long. Good for the take in for DeRozan. He'll pull up. Jumper's good. Back to a 7-point game. Jets trying really hard to make this push. And they have two trusted guards in Kobe and Deron Williams, and DeRozan on defense. It's really just a matter of turning that corner. It's been a long time since the Jets have held a lead. They're down by 7, 111-104 with 2:37 left in the fourth. This game, the battle of the LVs, and it's the visiting side, Las Vegas, who's had control for much of this game. Really got going with the bench players in the second quarter. And then the starters came in, and they took off from there. Here's Lou Williams going inside, draws the foul on Faried. 2:26 left here in the fourth quarter. And Lou Williams, who's conceded 30 points to Deron Williams, but himself has scored 20, is going to look to close the deal here for his team. He's able to knock down the first free throw. And able to knock down the second. 113-104. 9-point game, 2.5 left in the fourth. And Jeff Seymour is going to try to figure out something for his team to see if they can close the gap late. Next game on the Coliseum Sports Network is tomorrow, our international matchup, only time this season. Mexico City will head to London to take on the 0-3 Bulldogs. Will London get their first win against the Guerreros? You'll have to find out. Tune in tomorrow here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Floater is able to draw the foul for Kobe. That's only Westbrook's second. That shot goes up and in. Other matchups to look forward to in week one of our, or in the first week of our interconference portion of the schedule. It's week four. We have Alaska and Kansas City on Saturday, and then we close out the week back at the CenturyLink Center, Seattle at Omaha. So you have a high scoring team in the Racers, and you have a aggressive 3-point shooting team in Seattle. We'll see what fireworks ensue there. We've seen our share of fireworks here in Allentown. Here's Granger trying to fight his way inside. Jumper's blocked, collected by Hibbert, and he's able to go up and lay it in. Back up to a 9-point lead here for Vegas. Under 2 minutes left in the fourth. Here's Faried on the elbow. And Faried just hanging out here. Gets it to Bryant. He'll put up the long shot. And that's a 2-7-point game. Pass intended for Westbrook, and that's a turnover. So another door opens here for Lehigh Valley, but are they going to take advantage of it? Down by 7 with 1:36 left in the fourth. Looking ahead here, in week 5, Lehigh Valley's next challenge, they're going to have to head up to Anchorage to take on the Alaska Glacier Bears, while Vegas will be back home to host London. And just as the Jets have an opportunity, they lose it as the Silver Stars get the turnover. And while that's not a field goal, that turnover, that seemed a lot like a dagger to me. Here's Westbrook. He'll put it up over Bryant and miss. Williams rushing it up the floor. Gets it to Kobe. And that's no good. Rebound by Granger. Under a minute. Vegas up by 7. And it's looking like Lehigh Valley in their first interconference game will be handed their first loss of the season, while Vegas will be able to return to 500. Here's Griffin going inside. He's about to go for that jam, but he's fouled by Martin, and he'll have to earn his points at the line. .1 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. If Vegas is able to hold serve, they'll at least be in a holding pattern. They'll still be third in the Western Conference for now. Lehigh Valley, if they pick up the loss, they'll still be in first place in the East for the time being, as we'll have to wait and see how the rest of the week shakes out. Mexico City at London, Alaska at Kansas City, and Seattle at Omaha. This is your week 4 action here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Griffin able to get neither the free throws, and yet the Jets still not able to convert here. And we have a quiet PPL Center here, fairly quiet. It was a great turnout here, though, as it has been in the last home game they had last week. Good 9,000 people showing up for Allentown's first professional basketball team in a long time, playing in a beautiful new arena, which went through its first season of having tenants, of having events coming into the city. And both sides, both coaches calling it a day here as the reserves will step out onto the floor to close things out. Most points so far this season was Omaha in week 1. 121, so we won't reach that, but this could be tied for the third most for Vegas here, as it looks like they may very well hold the ball at the end with 117. And there it is, the Lehigh Valley Jets get their first loss of the season, and it comes off a scoring barrage by the visiting Las Vegas Silver Stars, 117-108. Glad you could join us here for some great CBL action. I'm Raymond Sims. Have a good one, everyone.